What's going on, guys? And can you believe it? It's already 2018 and I had to use my iPhone 6 in 2018, so I decided to make this video. It's kind of my experience, and basically I'm trying to answer the question, should you buy the iPhone 6 in 2018? And the answer is yes. Reason one, because it has a headphone jack. Now I'm just playing. Scratch all of that. So basically, I've been using the iPhone 6 for the past week because I had to send my iPhone 10 to Apple due to some issues. Who would have thought? Yes, my iPhone 10 has a screen issue, but we're not talking about the iPhone 10. We're here to talk about the iPhone 6. So I've had this iPhone 6 since it came out. I have the 6 and also the Plus model, which is the 6 Plus. So I'm talking about the 6 though. Anyways, I keep going off track. Let's get back on track. So it has been like through hell and back, guys. I dropped it, I lost it, I found it, I changed the screen and even the battery. So yeah, I gave it a good run for my money. Unfortunately though, I had to upgrade to iOS 11 because I needed to pair it with my Apple Watch. I say unfortunately because I lost my jailbreak. However, I've gotten used to it. I don't think the iPhone 6 has gotten used to it though, because it's still lagging behind and it's like it's stuck in 2017. I'm someone who uses my phone normally, like I listen to music, check my email, keep up with social, take pictures. Side note though, if you like taking pics, I definitely go for an iPhone 6s or an iPhone SE and not the 6. You'd have the option to like shoot in RAW if you ever get into that stuff, but that's if you're serious about photography on mobile. I just don't really take pictures on mobile that much, so the iPhone 6 is fine for me. Okay, enough of the chitter chatter. Let's see if the iPhone 6 is worth a purchase in 2018. Firstly, let's just breeze through all the key specifications. So it's a 4.7 inch display, 8 megapixel on the rear, a 1.2 megapixel on the front camera. Sounds funny, but it's not that bad. It's a resolution of 1750 by 1334 pixels, 1 gig of RAM. It sounds horrible, 1 gig of RAM on an Apple A8 chip, and it houses a 1810 milliampere battery. Guys, do not look at those specs. It sounds horrible in 2018, but in real life usage, it does an impressive job. So first off, we're gonna talk about the display and the camera. Now, the display in 2018 is pretty good, and to me, it's still a win. It's a bit washed out with the colors and lacks some sharpness. It's surely not a deal breaker. You wouldn't even realize any difference if you're coming from another cheap smartphone or a cheap Android phone. But since I was coming from the iPhone 10 and the Note 8, I was kind of a bit spoiled, so I could easily see the quality loss. The front and the rear camera is still way better than some smartphones released last year, and I still think it could compete with the Razer phone and the Essential phone's camera, and also most budget sub $300 phones that came out in mid to late 2017. Now, if you don't believe me, let's look at some shots I took with the iPhone 6, and I also compared it with some shots of the iPhone 10. I told you, the quality is still there. Performance wise, guys, It has the 1 gigabyte of RAM. It's holding up really well. I'm not saying it's like blazing like Usain Bolt speed or anything, but it can really, really run all the latest applications on the App Store, apart from some apps that support AR. So I compared it to the iPhone 7, and you're not gonna really see any performance differences with the day-to-day usage, but with the introduction of iOS 11, the overall fluidity has decreased, and sometimes you'd have a few lagging here and there, and the battery life drains a lot. So as mentioned earlier, guys, if you're killing this thing with like pushing tons of apps on it, using it non-stop, you will run into a lot of hiccups and slowdowns. However, if you use the phone like casually and not like a laptop, you'd have a lot more fluidity and little or no issues with performance. Same goes for the battery life. If you're a light user, you'll get through like a solid day, but if you use your phone a lot, Snapchat every 15 minutes, watching IG videos, stories, YouTubing, playing games, and just going nuts on this phone, you will need to put it on charge like every 3 hours or so. Remember, it's only an 1810 milliampere battery inside, and remember, Apple throttles performance based on the battery life now. So my performance usage may differ from yours, but if you want to be safe, you can always swap out the battery because Apple dropped the price. It's like $29 now, or you could buy the Apple iPhone battery case, the Apple iPhone 6 battery case. You see, Apple knew this was gonna happen. They made battery cases just for the iPhone 6. I think it's because of that small battery they had to do, because a lot of people were complaining about the battery life. So I'll have all the links down below if you want to purchase a Apple battery case in the future or something like that. Now guys, let's talk about the build quality. We all heard about the bend gate with the iPhone 6 and especially the iPhone 6 Plus. As mentioned earlier though, I've had this phone since day one, and up to this day I still cannot witness any bending whatsoever. I'm not saying like they don't bend, because I've seen a lot of complaints from users in the past about the bending. It feels way lighter than the iPhone 10 and the 6s and all the other iPhone models. To me, it's the thinnest iPhone Apple has ever made, and I know that sounds good, but to me that's not a great thing, because it's probably the reason why this phone is bending so much. So I would really recommend you guys to put a nice case on this device. The fingerprint scanner works really well, and I have no issues with it. It's not as fast as the iPhone 7 and the iPhone 8 Plus fingerprint scanner because it's the first gen, but it works every time. And to be honest, I realize how great the fingerprint scanner is, and I tend to miss it because I'm coming from the iPhone 10. I was like, whoa, I really kind of miss this fingerprint scanner. Also, with software updates, you will always see new updates for the next year or so. My best bet would be that you'd stop seeing software updates until iOS 13, which is a couple years from now. And to me, that's amazing, seeing that this phone is coming from iOS 8 and it was released 4 years ago. Not a lot of phones get that software longevity, which makes the older iPhones better each year. Now for pricing, I've seen a lot of prices fluctuate between $200 Canadian and $350 Canadian on reseller websites such as eBay, Letgo, or Kijiji here in Canada, because I don't think Apple sells these phones again. I think they released some last year, I'm not sure, but I honestly don't think Apple sells them anymore. Normally you could get a refurbished one for around $300 Canadian, which to me is a steal, especially if you get like from a carrier here in Canada. You could pay $0 up front for a 32 gig model for only $10 a month. To me, that's pretty decent if you're like a teenager and you don't have a lot of cash. Plus, this could be the stepping stone to let you guys know what rent feels like in the future. Now, the final question, should you buy this phone? For me, I couldn't live with this phone, guys. It really gets slow. I don't know if other YouTubers out there are telling you that it's useful. It's useful if you're not spending a lot of time on the phone. I spend a lot of time on my phone. I'm checking analytics, I'm doing homework, I'm doing group projects, I'm checking Instagram, I'm checking Shopify, I'm reselling stuff, doing all of that. The phone has to be fast. This phone really slowed down, guys. I had to walk with a power bank. It got hot over time. I'm in Canada right now. So when I went outside, the phone shut off because I think it's too cold or something like that. I had no issues with my iPhone 8 Plus or my iPhone 10 when I go outside. It wasn't like shutting off. So I think the phone has reached its limit, and I think 2018 is the year that we should stop buying the iPhone 6 for me personally. But as I said before, if you're not a hard user of the phone, if you're not killing the phone like a lot of apps and a lot, like, you know, using the phone to its max, you could really use this phone for a decent while, probably like a year or so. But to get a new contract and all that, if you're a grown man, you're a grown woman, I don't think the iPhone should be a phone that you buy in 2018. The best bet would be an iPhone 6S or iPhone SE, if you don't mind the size, or to get an iPhone 7. I think we should leave the iPhone 6 in 2017, and just that's my thoughts. If you have an iPhone 6 and you think it's worth buying in 2018, let me know your experience down below with the iPhone 6, guys. It's a great phone, it's decent, but because it has been out for so long, if you're using one that was fresh open from 2014, it will definitely face the consequences. But if you're buying a brand new one in 2018, I think you could really use that phone for one more year. That's my thoughts. Let me know your thoughts down below, guys. As always, love, peace, and tweaks. Happy New Year, and hope 2018 is the year that you guys crush it. Signing out.